always like to let it warm up before I start mowing, especially tall, wet grass. It's going to put a lot of strain on it. I'll let it warm up for a couple of minutes. Get all the juices flowing before we start beating on it. I've made one pass on it. I'm cutting it at 3 inches. So you can kind of tell here how tall the grass really is. I mean, that's like 6 inches tall. This is 3 inch cut. Sometimes it's hard to tell on camera how tall they really are, but this one's very overgrown. So I just edged out the perimeter. We're gonna start striping it up. And then I'll probably weed whack it, and then I'll probably hit it one more time just to get rid of all the grass clippings from the weed whacker. guys, so I got one pass on it. I got all the heavy out going this way. Now I'm gonna go this way with it, cross cut it to get it ultra smooth. Yeah, there is a few clumps that were left behind, which I'm gonna suck up because I will never leave this on a lawn. This will kill a lawn. Get these out. And yeah, see, there's another one over here. Then I'll start weed whacking. See how full we are with the hopper. Yep, we're full. Okay, time to dump. Alright guys, so you see how much cleaner it looks from me going this way with it now? There's no clumps, there's no debris in the lawn, everything's nice, even cut, that's what I'm looking for. Now, it's time to weed whack these edges, get them nice and sharp, the way they're supposed to be. Give you an angle from this view. I'm gonna get that nice and sharp with the weed trimmer, and then I'm gonna go back over it this way for the finished stripe, and it should look real nice. All right, so I got all the edging done with the weed whacker. Give you a quick shot. Just the way the edges should look, nice and crispy, nice and neat. Now, you see all this debris right here? I'm not gonna just blow that back into the lawn. I'm gonna blow it into this section that I haven't cut yet. I'm gonna suck all this up once I cut this. But let me show you something here. See how there's debris left in the yard from weed whacking? Look, you got something here. And see all up against the house here, it's messy. This is why I'm gonna go over it again with the lawnmower. And that'll all be nice and clean. It'll look like a nice rug. That's the way that should look, nice and clean. Clean edges, clean lawn. Happy customers, more business. That's it, guys.
right guys, here's the final result. Came out pretty nice. I think my customer will be very happy with this. All edged up nice. Nice clean lines. Look at the cut quality, guys. That's why I love walkers. Looks like a carpet. Nice edge on the sidewalk. Then we come into the backyard. This was real tall back here. Got this cut down. I double cut it. Came out nice back there too. I know some of you may ask, why wouldn't I just use the stander and cut it down first? Well, the reason why I didn't use the stander is because it doesn't really like wet grass. That AeroCore deck does not like wet grass. And what happens is, you're mowing, even if you're bagging it, the grass builds up underneath and at least chunks all over the yard. The walker won't do that if you go slow and take your time. It'll just suck everything up, but the key is you gotta go slow. If you don't go slow, you just clog it up. So that's why I used the walker today, and I'm glad I used the walker. It laid down an awesome cut. And I think the customer will be very happy with that job that we did. So, I appreciate you guys taking the time to tune into my videos. If you like what you see, please like, share, and subscribe to our channel. And we'll see you on the next one, guys. Bye.